Good morning. Well, I wanted to tell you, I have my Facebook page here. I also have a YouTube channel, Mama Stella's Whiz Bang. And on my YouTube channel, I will frequently post my morning coffee videos. Lots of times I will add to them, so it won't be just what was on the live, but I'll add additional stuff. And then I have things that I don't post on Facebook at all. But yesterday I had occasion to post something here on Facebook and on YouTube. Let me tell you the story, then I'm going to show you something. So a friend of mine had given me one of those glass domes that you can put above a bird feeder to prevent the rain from getting down on it and squirrels coming from above. I was going out to put it up, and I have, I'll show you. I have this slender grapevine that is running across my bird feeder area. And it gives extra birds places to perch. See, like that. So let me go out here and I'll show you what happened. Sometimes we have surprises in life that are good, sometimes that are bad, sometimes that are just surprising. So I went out here and I went to, to lift off that grapevine so I could fit that ring over the shepherd's crook. And I felt something smooth. And I thought, this isn't right. Excuse me. So I looked, and there is this guy. That's a milk snake. Let's see, where'd you go? He is coiled up in there. It's not possible to see up in there. Let's see. Yeah, the light adjustment helps a little bit. Anyway, so maybe about 3.5 feet long. No bigger around than a little bit more than my thumb at the fattest part. Okay, look, I don't have a super fat thumb. Wait a minute. It's not letting me adjust the focus. All right. I got a normal thumb, people, okay? Anyway, so, there he is. So he's starting to work his way back down this wire thing, and he's going to come down along here. Why is he doing this? I'm pretty sure it is, there we go. I'm pretty sure, there he is right there. And here's my normal thumb. I'm pretty sure that he's spending time here for the birds, because there's always lots of birds here. And how snakes hold very, very still. Anyhow, so when I reached for that grapevine, I also got a handful of snake. Well, it's a milk snake. They're not aggressive. It was probably, a foot away from my face. And, it kind of reared back a little bit. But if it was an aggressive snake, it could have struck at me. But it just kind of turned around and started crawling back up the grapevine and up into the ceiling there of the back patio. And I was wondering if it was going to come back this morning. You know, I always, when I'm outside and I'm going to put my hand somewhere, I'm always checking to see if there are bugs or spiders or something. I don't have to worry about lizards because lizards are very quick to scamper away. Now I'm going to have to pay attention, make sure there's no snakes. I mean, you know, it's not an aggressive snake, but you can rile anything up. And I certainly, you know, don't want to reach for something and end up coming up with a snake, right? I used to work with snakes, so it's not that big a deal. I don't have some unreasonable fear, but I have a reasonable fear. I don't want to get bitten, you know, by aggravating a snake. I mean, so anyway, it's so interesting. So I made a little video, and yesterday in the video, I followed it as it crawled back down the grapevine. And then and in the video also you can see it drinking. Oh my goodness, it takes its little head and kind of goes like this, and you can see its throat moving as it's swallowing. Guess there, you know, was maybe a little tiny puddle of raindrops because it was raining at the time. Anyway, just really very interesting. So hopefully that's not put anybody off their breakfast or their morning coffee. Certainly hasn't put me off my morning coffee. Let me get some milk here. Okay, here we go. Okay, I need something to put the coffee in. Let's see, what do we have here? Oh, I think I'll use my nice fall cup because it's, you know, it's fall kind of weather with a little bit of drizzle here and there, and leaves are falling, and in some places I guess they're picking apples. Anyway, so let me put some milk in here. So in my backyard now of my apartment complex, you know, I've told you we have little patches of woods all through the apartment complex. And so I've had on my back porch possums, feral cats. These are cats that, you know, probably initially somebody put some kittens out, or, you know, threw a cat out of a car or whatever, and the cats had babies. And anyway, these cats are growing up in the woods, and then people are also helping to propagate this whole mess by putting out food for them. I mean, hey people, if a cat's living in the wild, it can find its own food. You don't have to give it food. And, you know, then the cats have more babies, and you know how cats multiply. Anyway, it's very annoying, especially having a dog who gets very excited when he sees a cat and wants to, you know, rush at it. I've pretty much gotten Grayson over, you know, wanting to rush after squirrels, pretty much. But cats, that's another thing. And also, Grayson thinks that cats are going to be friendly. You know, like he'll see a cat and that tail is wagging like, oh, I'm gonna have some fun. But the kind of fun, like friendly fun, he's never been close up and personal with a cat, especially a feral cat. Well, anyway, oh, and so also in my backyard, I've got several different kinds of lizards and some nice box turtles, one of them particularly large. Let's see, possums, cats, box turtles, lizards, oh, frogs and toads. And now, seems to be a resident snake. It's okay. I mean, it certainly has, it has a right to be here. I was going to say more of a right than I do. We kind of both have rights. Okay, so let's see here. What can I have? I want to have a smaller cup this morning. Because this is a smallish mug. Oh, golly, let me see. Gran Lungos. Oh, the only Gran Lungo I have is a decaf fortado. So, you know what? I'll have a double. I'll have a double espresso scuro. This is my favorite one. And I'll run through a couple of times. kind of give me a little bit extra coffee there. So, you know, it's interesting. I was saying I don't have some unreasonable fear of snakes. Honestly, there are some people, you know, like some people are afraid of heights, or some people, they have, I don't know, they're afraid of clowns, whatever. I happened to see that on a murder mystery last night that was predicated on, you know, somebody having a fear of clowns. Anyway, so sometimes, for whatever reason, you know, could be something when happened when you were a baby, or somehow your brain chemistry is just that way, you can have fears of things that you don't even have a chance to think, should I be afraid of this, or what can I do? You don't have a choice in how to react immediately. That adrenaline starts pumping and you are a mess, okay? And there actually are ways to deal with these kind of things, but it's not like if you don't have that. Like, for example, well, I know so many people that are afraid of snakes because, you know, I used to work with snakes many years ago, and reptiles and amphibians. Well, anyway, you know, you just show them a snake, even a picture of one, and they're, you know. But, like, for me, when I see a snake, I have interest in it. Of course, you know, I'm not stupid. I mean, yesterday when I grabbed that snake, I didn't know what kind it was. I didn't know what it was gonna do, so I ran back into the house, and I even got my phone. I wanted to take a picture of it, because I kind of assumed that it was going to also be going, and running back wherever it came from, or slithering back. And I was apparently in such a tizzy that the whole time the phone was pointed, the lens was looking this way instead of looking out. You know what it looked like? It looked like somebody had turned their video on their phone on and then dropped the phone down the stairs. I mean, you know, bump, bump, bump. It was all crazy. And I was so disappointed that I didn't get a picture. But then I started looking around for where did it go, you know, and I saw that it had crawled up. I figured it was up on my upstairs neighbor's balcony. And then I saw that head sticking out like this morning. And I thought, yes. And I stood at the sliding glass doors for the longest time watching it. And I did get some good video of it, which is, it's on my Facebook page and it's also on my YouTube channel. Well, anyway, so yeah, when you're afraid of something, there are ways to deal with those fears, whether it's an unreasonable fear or, you know, you just, I don't feel comfortable being around that. If it's that kind of thing, you know, if you want to feel more comfortable, you can. You know, some people have a fear of, like, being in front of a big crowd or public speaking or, anyway, all kinds of things. Well, I'm going to go have my coffee. Can't remember if I had another point this morning. Look at that beautiful crema. So for those of you who have not been watching me for long, with the kind of coffee maker I have, what now? What's out there now, Grayson? Oh, let me see. It spins those coffee capsules around at a very, very high speed, and forces the water through, and as it goes through, the oils in the coffee get mixed up with air. What do you see, Grayson? I don't see anything, probably a cat. Anyway, so when the oils in the coffee get mixed up with the air at a high speed like that, it forms a froth. Like a good bubble bath, sort of, high quality bubble bath. And that is called crema, C-R-E-M-A, which is an Italian word. And what you're supposed to do is you gently mix that back in to the coffee to return those good oils into it. But it also gives the coffee a sort of a creaminess and a little bit more of not a thickness so much, but a consistency on your tongue that's really nice. Golly, that's delicious. So, double espresso scuro this morning, and look up, watch out for snakes.